Good morning, church. It's a Wednesday morning, and I hope you're doing well. It's good to be able to check in with you. I hope that you're staying connected to the community as best you can through your connection groups, through our worship service. And I want to thank you for your flexibility with our link last week. I am so sorry that it was a mess, and we had a hard time getting it right, but we did get it right, and thank you for participating in our worship service this past week. I'm excited to bring you the next message in our series called Crossover. We're going to be talking about how we cross over from our past to our future this week, and I'm really excited to talk to you about that topic. You know, the past can really hold us back, and it doesn't have to. And so I'm looking forward to bringing you this message, and we'll be looking both at the Old Testament and the New Testament as we move on in our crossover series. Well, hopefully we've turned the corner in some of the restrictions and some of the ability to get out and be in gatherings of some kind. We should have a better idea next week. This week we'll certainly still be in a virtual world. Next week we may begin to see the possibilities and when the possibility will arise that we will be able to meet together in some format in person. Now, you know, my hopes had been that we'd have a kind of a mass reopening, and that's not going to happen. This is going to come in gradual stages, and I don't exactly know what those stages are going to look like. So bear with us. We'll keep you informed about all the options and the opportunities that we have. We certainly want to abide by the best guidelines and the best possibilities of what we can do. And so we want to make sure that we're being mindful of everyone's health, but also being mindful of our role as a church. And so we're trying to balance all of those things. And so I'll encourage you, as we think about getting back together, remember that if you're a hugger, if you're a big handshaker, this is going to be hard getting back together. That's kind of like me. I love to shake hands, hug people's necks. And this is going to be one of those times where we have to be mindful to go ahead and remember that the health needs of someone else are more important than how we operate. And so it's kind of trying to restructure my brain just a little bit. So I encourage you to do the same as we look forward to that day that it's coming where we will at least be back together in some form. It won't be everything at once, but we do look forward to that. In the meantime, continue to reach out to your connection group leader or to me or to Luke or Deanna. If there's anything we can do for you, please let us know. We care for you. We miss you. And we are trying to do the best we can to stay in touch. And we know that we serve a great God, and He's doing some great things. And so many people have connected with us in our virtual church. I hope you will connect with us in person when we're able to do that. But in the meantime, keep pressing on, because that's what God's people do so well. We press on, and we will press on, and we will endure through this. I love you, and we'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.